children, back to the class. So dear children, in last class we were discussing about the Shakuntala too. So yeah, lesson number 16. In that Shakuntala too, what we were discussing, we were talking about that how she lost her ring. While she was taking bus, she lost her ring. What the who has given? Dushyanta has given. Then she had a lot of fear there. Why she had a little bit? Because Durvasa, the sage Durvasa, has given her means he made that the what do you say? He has cursed her. He has cursed her if the ring what you are wearing that was given by Dushyanta. If you are losing that ring, that Dushyanta will not be remembering the past. Whatever happened, he married you, everything he will forget. If you show the ring what you are having, because on that ring Dushyanta name is there. So if you are showing this ring only, the Dushyanta can recognize you. Otherwise he will be forgetting you. That is the reason. So she became more worried. If I go means now he cannot remember me. Then immediately she was going to meet Dushyanta. Then by the time this had happened, then she was anyhow she went to the court. When she went there, she said to the king, "I am Shakuntala, your dear one, whom you married in the hunt of Kanva Muni." So she went to the Dushyanta, the king of Dushyanta, and said, "I am your wife Shakuntala. You have married me in the hunt of Kanva Muni. There you have married me." Dushyanta was puzzled. Dushyanta was puzzled. Puzzled means what? Puzzle means confused. What we can say? Confused. Puzzle. So, confused. He was very confused there. Then, he could not remember. He married any girl in the ashram. Shakuntala tried to remind him of their meeting and their marriage. How could you forget everything? Shakuntala asked with the tears in her eyes. Finally, she left the palace. So she tried her level best, but he was not at all remembering. Where did I meet you? How I married you? Everything he is asking her. He forgot everything. Then finally, with a lot of tears, heavy hearted, she came out of the palace. After a few days, a soldier caught a fisherman who was trying to sell the ring which had Dushyanta's name. So after a few days, one man came and he was trying to sell the ring which the Dushyanta name is there. Then immediately they caught. The fisherman had caught the ring when he cut the fish. He had caught from the river. So he thought, "I went to the river and I caught some fishes. I catched some fishes. Then when I was cutting, in the fish stomach I caught this ring." So, because when she was taking bath, the one fish has swollen with the water. When the water it is, the fish opens them. So, immediately the ring went to the fish mouth. Though, when the fisherman was cutting that, then inside that, he caught that ring. The soldier presented the fisherman and the ring to the king. So he has took the soldier has taken the fisherman and a ring to the king. On seeing the ring, the Dushyanta remembered everything. So when he saw that ring, immediately he remembered. He married. He went to the ashram forest, and there he went to the ashram and he met Shakuntala, and finally they married. Everything he remembered. His mind was filled with the guilt. Guilt means what is the meaning? Guilt means wrong doing. So he felt that how wrong I am. So he felt that how wrong I am. How I forgot Shakuntala. How I made her to cry and go from here. Everything he remembered, and he felt very guilty. He wanted to see Shakuntala at once. Messengers were sent everywhere, but nobody could trace Shakuntala. So, because everybody has sent all the soldiers he sent in different places to to search for Shakuntala. They went sent to the ashram also. She was not there. Every place they searched, wherever they knew, but they did not come. Dushyanta spent his days in a great sorrow. So he felt very unhappy. His sorrow means he was not at all happy. He was in unhappy. He was spending all the days. One day the king was wandering in the mountains. He came across a handsome and brave boy who was playing with a lion cub. So lion cub means lion baby. So when the Dushyanta went somewhere, and then when he was roaming surrounding that mountains, he was just moving here and there, wandering. Then he found one boy that also very brave. Brave means why? He is playing with which baby? The lion cub. So with the lion cub, that boy is playing. The king asked his name. The boy replied, "My name is Sarvadaman. I am the son of King Dushyanta." Dushyanta came to know that he was his own son and picked him up. So when the boy said, "My name is Sarvadaman and I am the son of King who Dushyanta." So the Dushyanta came to know that he is only his own son. He picked him up. He wanted to ask the boy about his mother. Just then he saw Shakuntala coming. So by the time he saw that Shakuntala was just coming that side. Just then Dushyanta told her how he had bought the ring and how he remembered everything. So he told, "Sorry, I am very sorry, Shakuntala, I forgot. But when I got a ring in my hand, so I got this ring. When I got the ring in my hand, I remembered everything. So for everything, whatever I have done, I am very, very sorry to release it." Shakuntala forgave him, the king, because she knew that she also forgave him because she knew that this was all happened because of Durvasa Muni's sharp vision. So because of his curse, because of that only all these things had happened in their life. So knew that it was not his fault. The Dushyanta asked Shakuntala and Saradaman to return their palace. So he told, "Please come with me, I will take you to my palace," he said. Just then they heard a voice from heaven. So when they were moving back to palace, immediately they heard one voice from the heaven. So from the sky, so just from the God they had one voice. It spoke to Dushyanta, "Take your faithful wife and son with you. Your son shall be the greatest ruler of all the times. Call him Bharat." So what they told, that voice said, "Your wife is very faithful wife. You have very faithful wife. So take care of your faithful wife and your beloved son. And your son will be the great ruler in the coming up. And everybody remember your son's name and call him as a Bharat." So that time onwards, Dushyanta started call his son as a Bharat. So this was the story about the Shakuntala, how she finally met her husband, and finally with the her baby, a boy baby, they went happily to the palace and they stayed happily, and the son became very popular after some time. This is about the story of Shakuntala. So dear children, I have already given you the everything. So please write and the textbook exercise all, please do it in your textbook. Write down whatever I have given. So read the lesson once again so that you can understand it more clearly. I hope you have enjoyed the lesson. Thank you.